Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we'll be studying two types of inhibition, competitive inhibition and non-competitive inhibition. What if I say that apart from substrate, there is something else which is called as inhibitor that binds to the active site of an enzyme? Inhibition. Inhibitors are the substances that bind to the active site of an enzyme and they try to hamper or stop the reaction. There are two types of inhibitors, competitive inhibitors and non-competitive inhibitors. Competitive inhibitors, they fight along with that substrate for the active site present on an enzyme. Substrate as well as the inhibitor both will have competition among themselves so that they can attach to the active site of an enzyme. And if the substrate concentration is lower and the concentration of inhibitor is greater, then the inhibitor will bind to the active site present on an enzyme and form a product which is not required, a product which will be not good for the body or the organism. This is competitive inhibition. Competitive inhibition is a fighting between substrate and an inhibitor. The next type of inhibition is non-competitive inhibition. In this type of inhibition, there is no fighting involved between the substrate as well as the inhibitor. Here, the inhibitor is a poison. It could be cyanide, for example. Now, this inhibitor directly binds to the active site present on the enzyme, and the active site of an enzyme is blocked in such a way that there is no chance for a substrate to attach or to fight, and the end result is a product that is poisonous, which ultimately leads to the death of an organism. An example of this could be various chemicals, rat poisons and so on. So let us see the various type of inhibition. Inhibitors. There are two types of inhibitors. The first one is competitive inhibitor. In this reaction, both inhibitor and substrate compete or fight for the binding site of an enzyme. Basically, both of them fight for the active site present on the enzyme. And if inhibitor concentration is high, it displays enzyme. If the concentration of inhibitor is much greater than the substrate, this inhibitor binds to the active site present on an enzyme. The working of a competitive inhibitor is in this manner. An enzyme will have its active site. To this active site, there are two things that are fighting to bind to the active site. The first one is a substrate and the next one is an inhibitor. Always the inhibitor concentration, if it is more, this inhibitor will bind to the active site of an enzyme, and active site is blocked by an inhibitor. So the product which will be formed is not required, and this type of inhibition is called as competitive inhibition. non-competitive inhibitors. In this type of inhibitors, poisons react with various functional group of an enzyme. They inhibit the normal reaction catalyzed by the enzyme and the result is death. Basically, here there is no fighting between the substrate and the inhibitor. Directly, the inhibitor binds the enzyme. An example could be various poisons. The working of non-competitive inhibitor is in this manner. There is an enzyme which will have its active site as well as the functional group. There will be substrate plus inhibitor, but here the substrate will not fight with the inhibitor for the functional group or the active site of an enzyme. Directly, the inhibitor will bind to the functional group or the active site of an enzyme, and then the active site is blocked by the inhibitor and it results in the formation of a certain compound which leads to the death of an organism. So students, in this part we have studied about two types of inhibitors, competitive and non-competitive. I hope you all are clear about the two types of inhibitors. Thank you.